everybody on the Dev Hall Show. We got a special guest, man. We got a special guest. I met this guy through a friend of mine. I actually met him a couple days ago. I met him, you know, through social media in a strange way. We was all in a group message, and we was all just basically brainstorming different ideas, all cool people basically in a group message, just chatting about a lot of positive things. You know, he had this page called Broken Chain Gang.
Broken Chain Gang, yeah.
Right, so when I was on his page, you know, I was like, I don't know what's going on. You know, he got a lot of different things that he's posting. You know, it's different that you don't see that many people posting themselves, but you see people posting content.
Yeah.
You know, so my man Trey, you know, he introduced me to him, basically saying like, yo, he cool folks. You know, he's like us. You know, on a positive path, doing a lot of good things in the community, and basically he's for the community.
Right.
So I just recently met him. They came down for my birthday weekend.
Turned up.
Oh yeah, definitely 28? Yeah, 28. You already know, man.
Yeah.
And we got a chance to like basically kick it, ladies and gentlemen. We got Milan in the building, man. Yeah. Talk to him, bro.
What's going on, y'all? You know, Broken Chain Gang. So look, you know, yeah, like we met, like, and she, my man been telling me about you whole time for a little while. He's telling my man, Dev got this, you know, show, he popping, and you said y'all went to school together and all right. That shit too. And he was just like good people. And I know my man Trey, he just good people in general. So like, you know, we met, you know, through him.
Right.
And tapped in. But like the Broken Chain Gang is basically what that's about. It's just about young black men coming together and really building a community of young black men that's trying to do some positive shit together, you know what I mean? And mm-hmm. basically the whole concept behind Broken Chain Gang is just to break the cycle, because I feel like niggas are in a cycle right now where we kind of like, you know, certain shit gets passed down through generation, you know what I mean?
Right.
And like being that nigga, that one nigga in a group or mm-hmm. in your family or whatever that breaks that cycle of, you know, the negative shit that's been going on, I feel like within the black community, you know what I mean? Some of us been going through some like fucked up shit as far as like our families
right.
and shit like that, and that shit just kind of like continues on down the generational line, you know what I mean?
Wow.
So it's like breaking that cycle of just, you know, doing, you know, and just getting on some positive shit, you know what I mean?
And by you saying that, like, I feel like a lot of people can relate to that, mm-hmm. not no matter where you're from. Ladies and gentlemen, he's from D.C. as well, you know, so he's not even from
PG County.
Or PG, you know. Yeah. A lot of people, like myself, I still consider that D.C., yeah, but, you know, yeah. PG County. And, you know, so I can relate on that aspect as well.
Man.
Now, by you trying to collide and get everyone in the community to come together.
So it's really like young black men, man, because I feel like, you know, especially young black men, man, it's a lot of issues that we got within our community as far as like the young black men that I see, you know what I mean? As far as like stuff that I've even, you know, struggled with personally, you know
like
what I mean? Mental health, you know, issues, and just figuring out ways to deal with stuff like that. You know, building brands like this shit right here, man. That's why I said I salute this shit, man, because it's about building brands too, man, because in business, you know, mm-hmm. niggas linking up together and just doing business and building up the economical structure in the black community.
Right.
You know what I mean? I just think that's so important for the community, man.
What type of step or like what goal do you have
with the Broken Chain Gang?
So
the Broken Chain Gang basically was just really just about a message.
Okay.
You know what I mean? And really getting that message out there and really just pushing a positive message to where, like, you know, we all really can kind of like, you know, get a different angle on, you know, what our potential is as
right.
far as like what we can actually do as young black men, and like really doing something positive. Like you see people like my man Nipsey. I represent my man Nipsey right now.
Mm-hmm.
Like salute to my man, because he was just off a positive wave of really making something out of nothing. You know what I mean? And really
right.
taking it from the mud and really making it something and really buying your block. Like, you know, doing shit like that. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And it's about, to me, it's just about building. So spreading a message like that and really creating a network also where like young black men can really come together in politics and really, like we was talking about behind the scenes, like sharing resources, things of that sort, so mm-hmm. we can build and not feeling like we got to do the shit alone, you know
right.
what I mean?
So is this some type of organization that you like are
yeah
so
yeah like a community yeah in
okay.
a sense to where like, you know, people can really tap into. It's almost like a you know, a situation like where like I have like a page set up to where like people can come to and get like resources
okay.
to where like, all right, we, you know, we all tapped in and we can get resources from like this one page to where like, all right, if I'm going through this, I can go to this page and get these different type of resources to where like I'm dealing with this type of situation, that type of situation, whether it be mental health, finances, trying to, you know, do some entrepreneur type shit,
right.
things of that sort. You know what I mean?
But what made you like decide to?
I don't know, bro. It was just because it was something that I felt like I needed, you know, coming up, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just like, all right, well, I feel like it's a lot, and I feel like I see a lot of young black men, like my little cousins and stuff like that, going through stuff like that. We like, they feel like they don't have no outlets.
Right.
You know what I mean? And they don't feel like they have no resources. They don't feel like nobody cares or anything like that. So it's like, really showing these young niggas, especially the youngest, man, because it's like, you know, we especially at our age, you know, we getting up there in age, 28, 30. Mm-hmm. So it's like, I feel like it's our responsibility, too, to reach back to the youngest and really try to pull them up and help them in different situations to where, like, they need certain guidance. You know what I mean?
Now, let me ask you this. Now, you got some people that would say stuff like, man, it's always someone that wanted to do something positive in the community.
Right.
But we don't see that many people actually making some type of change.
Right.
Or it's not, Facts. It has no type of longevity.
Facts.
Like, what's your answer to that?
So, with that is like, when you, my whole answer to that is the fact that I will, if that's the case, or that is the case, honestly, because I see it, you know what I mean? But like, I feel like in order to be in a position to where like, you can do that, you have to have, you know, a certain type of influence over that community or a certain type of influence within that community, kind of like, you know, to be able to provide people what they need, you know what I mean? Because, I mean, granted, think about it, people going through what they're going through is like, all right, you know, some people are survival mode, you know what I mean? So like, you know, it's like, all right, well, certain shit people just don't want to hit because it's like, it's not going to put money in my pockets, not going to put bread on my table, whatever the case may be. So like really being able to provide people with jobs and things of that sort to where like they can be like, all right, well, now I can really feed my family, stuff like that. So like, me with the whole switching over to, you know, what made me switch over to the doing the what's it called, broken chain marketing, you know what I mean? That right there was like, all right, well, now right, with this right here, I can build up a skill set personally to where like I can really help black owned businesses and black, you know, black people in the community to help get their stuff out there,
okay,
you know, through, you know, e-commerce, you know, doing stuff online, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So in that right there, that piece right there allows me to, you know, build up the capital to like, cause I want to give back to the community and stuff like that. So I'm not even on that level to be able to do stuff like that. I mean, I have the heart for it, but it's like, I know what people are. It's like, all right, well, like if you're not really touching the people in a way that they feel like they need help in, then they not really, they don't want to hear the shit.
Exactly. You know what I mean? Now, the reason I say that because there's so many people that be wanting to do certain different things in the community.
Right.
And I be for it. I be like, hey man, I like that, man. A lot of people need some type of guidance, like, especially in today's society, the young generation, and like throw it off.
Yeah, but I know right now I don't have the resources to do that. So like, dude, right now, just starting off, it's just that's why I was promoting this shit on the page, like just a whole positive message is like, all right, you know, just highlighting young black men in general, you know, whether it be, you know, famous people or whether it be, you know, people coming up or whatever the case may be, to kind of like show people like, look, man, this niggas out here really doing some positive shit. We don't have to be off no nut shit. Right. You know what I mean? So it's like, all right. You know, putting that message out there, but like, and then when I get to that level of where I can give back, I feel like we all need to really click up and really start, you know, doing certain shit together. And I see it, you know what I mean? It's funny because I see the shit, you know what I mean? So it's like, that's what I'm for, though. That's what it's about, in a sense.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just trying to narrow down to this one thing, like, because when you got the broken chain game, you basically is trying to bring people together.
Yeah, it's basically promoting a message for real.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
To bring people together, where we were just talking about, like, you know, the whole trust issue with, like, niggas really, like, they don't really, you know, it's hard to you really even trust some niggas sometimes. It's like, you don't really know what type of anger they coming from. It's like, but, like, you got to get past that sometimes when you're trying to do business. Right, yeah, right. And it's like, you can't do everything by yourself. So it's not like, oh, yeah, I figured this out. I'm a road dolo. Mm. And don't get it twisted. Certain situations will make you feel that way. But at the same time, every situation is not the same.
Right.
So it's like, all right, to open up and expand, it's like, all right, well, I know Broken Chain Gang, if I go to this community of niggas that are kind of like a part of this community, this organization, it's like, all right, well, I know these niggas ain't off no wild shit. They really trying to build, you know what I mean?
And that's why I
and
really
just providing, my bad, I ain't in the control, but really just providing like the resources and the people.
And that's why I think you should have energy. The organization. You're saying, you don't have the resources, like everything will happen. You know, time will come.
For sure.
You know, time will tell, but at the end of the day, like, I feel like if you generate the organization, like, and it's not just in the PG or wherever. It can be wherever, all over. Like, you know, not just an online thing.
Right, facts.
Like, by you saying the resources and a lot of different things that you can promote, there's, like, different avenues you're touching.
Right, facts.
So I feel like, how can I say, it can be some type of, not a boys and girls club, because we're not talking no activities, things of that sort.
Yeah.
But as far as, like, us, like, networking, us, facts, like, doing different things and coming together as a black community.
Yeah.
I think that would be very beneficial. That's why I'm saying it goes different. It coincides with your name, the Broken Chain.
Right. I don't know if that makes sense. Nah, it's all good. Nah, but I think the whole what you was basically saying is like, kind of like creating a space or a hub to where like we can kind of all, like everybody can tap into that.
Yeah, and kind of like different locations.
In different locations, right.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. But I think the internet really is like the easiest way to do that right now. But like having like chapters in different cities, I think that'd be lit. But like having the resources to do that. But like we tapped into Philly, so like, you know, once I get this shit really locked all the way in, you already know.
No. We want to let them know your Instagram and like social media things and that sort.
So yeah. Bro, at Broken Chain Gang, y'all can follow me on there. And you know, I kind of slowed down a little bit because, like I said, I've been focusing on the Broken Chain marketing. Like, what that is basically a design agency to where, like, you know, you people can come there to get their websites and stuff designed. Black-owned businesses. I'm only working with black-owned businesses. Mm-hmm. But like, so black-owned businesses come in and they can get their website designed. And then I'm actually about to add some more services onto that. You know, like social media marketing and stuff like that. Okay. But like, I want to help black-owned businesses promote their brand online.
So this is about to be a whole brand.
Oh, facts. Yeah.
I like this, man. Yeah. I like where it's going because it's like you don't have that many people that's out here like helping. Like I always say in all my episodes, you know, really having the time out to really think of the community. A lot of people think of themselves, you know. And this right here, I'm trying to get it out of him. Like what made him want to do, like really want to do this, but like.
Oh yeah, I mean, it's because back, man, Slim, growing up, I mean, you just see so much shit, and now you just see how like some, you know, people divided, man, like how divided we could be at sometimes, man. It's like, for me, it was just always like, man, like, it don't have to be like that. It don't have to be that way. But that's how shit is. It's like, I can't, you know what I mean?
Right.
It's just how people are sometimes, you know what I mean? But it's like, it don't have to be that way. So that's where my heart was at. It was like, man, all right, well, let me kind of like try to, you know, through my energy, push that out there and kind of like, you know, speak that into the world, you know what I mean? Because it's like, that's how I feel. I feel like I feel like there's different ways out here that we can link up, multiple ways that we can link up and go ahead and get to where we need to get to as far as like, you know, individual goals. But it's like, everybody got their individual goal, but that actually, it's funny because we can all link up to reach our individual goals. You know what I mean?
And it's funny.
To help promote, you know what I mean? Help promote, like this right here, bro.
Yeah, it's funny that you just mentioned goal, because I was just about to ask you, like, what is your end goal for the Broken Chain Game?
End goal, honestly, will be able to have and really, like I said, it's really like an online community that I wanna do. But like, I do wanna do chapters. That'll be the end goal.
Okay.
Really have chapters in different cities. But like, we having like meetups and really even like schools, bro. Like, like you ever been to like, you know, any like meetups, you know, like regular meetups, like business networking meetups and stuff like that. Okay. To where like,
might
you
be
know,
a different term, but we call it like networking events or something.
Yeah,
like that.
Networking events. Yeah. But like having that for black young black men, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I think that'd be
and
great.
Really linking up when we talk about entrepreneurship, we talking about mental health issues, we talking about relationship issues, whatever the case, whatever, you know, because we go through so much, bro. And we feel like we always got to deal with this shit by ourselves, and I feel like we don't have to do that. Right. You know what I mean? Like, it's so, resources out here that we.
So all the resources will be all black people.
Yeah, definitely facts. You know what I mean? And you got older, you got the OGs telling, you know, talking, you know, telling the youngers about their experiences with certain shit, because we all done been, even though we all go through different shit. So somebody there that probably been through what you've been through.
Right,
you know what I mean?
Right,
that can tell you how they dealt with it and what the outcome was. And you can take it or leave it. But at the same time, it's so many resources out here, man, that kind of can help us push through, you know, those mental barriers, those anything that we face in life. You know what I mean?
Well, you got a lot of people in the young generation that have problems with listening to older people,
and that's the way I took it with the Broken Chain Gang too. Is like, you know, and that's why I haven't been really posting a lot about me doing a lot of talking behind the camera as far as like what I think we should do with the black community, because it's like, all right, well, they're gonna be like, well, who is this nigga? But like, yeah,
no,
facts.
It's the opinion.
Yeah, so it's, yeah, but it's like, it's like, I would like, if I push, you know, somebody that they really look up to, like somebody that's iconic or whatever the case may be.
Maybe they'll
listen to that. You know what I mean? So like, what I was doing with that is just taking snips from like interviews from, you know, people that, you know, that really had that influence over the black community and young black men, and really taking snippets of their interviews and just posting the positive shit that they were talking about in that, whether it be, you know, dealing with, like I said, economics, you know what I mean, relationship issues, or, you know, mental health issues, anything, you know, finances, all that. So it's like, you know, just pushing that message out there, where I just really think that message is important for us, because it's like, you know, we can be lost. I was at one point lost, you know what I mean, in my situation. So it was like, you know, and really what really helped turn my shit around is I just noticed that I kept doing the same shit over and over again and kept getting the same fuck ass results. You know what I mean? I was like, I kept running against this brick wall, and it was like, man, I felt like I was like, man, it's time to make a change. Like, I can't keep doing the same shit and expect a different result. You know what I mean? Right, I got to switch it up and do something different. You know what I mean? So, like, then that's when I tapped into, like, personal development and stuff like that. So, and that right there really just took everything mentally for me. It's helped me out a lot mentally to kind of, like, grow beyond some of the struggles that I was going through.
Now, I actually wanted to just say, like, you sound like a man wearing different hats.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, you got a lot of different, like, resources. And when I say resources, like, the stuff that you're plugged into.
Right.
And you might not have the sources that you want
to, tap into, right.
Yeah, but, like, the resources that you, like, you educate.
I'm resourceful, bro, and I'm a high believer in, like, self-education, too. You know what I mean? Because, like, school is cool, you know what I mean? But they're not going to tell you certain shit that you go through in real life, you know what I mean? So, like, I feel like, you know, being able to self-educate yourself as well and really seek that, like, yearn for, because I feel like that's the way we get beyond some of these walls that we keep hitting.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the way we get beyond that is really just standing on the shoulders of giants, bro.
Right.
The niggas that been through it before.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? And reading about them or listening to them and really like tapping into like, or even having a mentor. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Somebody that really that been through the shit that you're going through and really can tell you how to maneuver through this situation so you don't have to keep, you know what I mean, be stuck. You know what I mean? And niggas be feeling like, I know I was there, and I still be having those moments where I feel like I'm stuck, but it's like, all right, well, you got to figure out a way to get through this. And it's another obstacle.
Well,
you see what I'm saying?
I do understand what you're saying, and I feel like a lot of people like our age, you know, and we look young, so a lot of people are going to gravitate towards anymore anyway, because it's like, all right, you know what? I'd rather like listen to someone that look like us or that's like
versus a dude that's in a suit and tie.
Yeah, I mean, like, I was like that when I was younger. You know, I'm trying what you guys say, old head, like, you know, thinking that sort. But you listen, if your older cousin is like maybe 21 or something talking
the cool,
to you.
Yeah, the cool
you
know, cousin. Yeah,
he was 16 a couple years ago.
Yeah.
Maybe he can relate. He went through this, you know, things in that sort. This ain't back in my heyday, like what older people say.
Right, right.
You know, so I can understand that.
Right.
But ladies and gentlemen, we got Milan in the building, man. You know, broken chain gang in the damn game.
Broken chain gang, broken chain gang.
You know, anything you want to say before we end this episode?
Nah, man. I mean, anybody, you know, definitely follow the page, Broken Chain Gang, and then also tap in with, you know, the online marketing. You know what I mean? The Broken Chain Marketing. We definitely doing all the websites for a good price, man. I got y'all $500 for a website, starting on $500 for a website.
Mm-hmm.
And that's cheap, man.
Right.
That's a good price for a website, bro. I mean, you know what I mean? So it's like, you know, I'm really trying to do work in the community, honestly, and help black-owned businesses grow. That's why I said, tap in with me, man.
I'll see you in the morning, man. The dead of awesome.